Hello students, today I am starting new chapter, that is solid state and introduction of solids. So as we all know that solids possess different properties. Solids have definite shape, size and volume. Solids are almost incompressible in nature as compared to liquid and gases. Solids have short intermolecular distances and the intermolecular forces are very strong in solids. And in solids, they possess the definite geometric pattern. Then move to the classification of solids. Classification of solids on the basis or on the basis of the properties exhibited by different solids. On the basis of nature present in their constituent particles. That is, constituent particles means atoms, ions and molecules. So they are broadly classified in two categories. One is crystalline solid and one is amorphous solid. So here are the properties of crystalline solids. Crystalline solids are those substances which possess definite geometric pattern. Means definite geometric patterns, and the important one is they are long range order. Means long range order means that they possess the definite geometric pattern over the long period of range. And on the other hand, amorphous solids are irregular in arrangement and they are short range order. Means in initial stage they exhibit a simple geometric pattern, but after some time they becomes irregular in nature. Then next is the crystalline solids are true solids because they have definite geometric pattern, and amorphous solids are known as pseudo solids or supercooled liquids. Then next property is crystalline solids are anisotropic in nature while amorphous solids are isotropic in nature, or we can use the term anisotropy or isotropy. So in this case, in crystalline solids, the anisotropic behavior is that it possesses different physical property in different directions. Means the physical property like electrical conductance, magnetic property, mechanical conductance and refractive index. Like these physical property have different values in different directions. And on the other part, isotropic behavior of amorphous solids, they have same physical property in all directions. And the examples of crystalline solids are metals like copper, gold, iron and NaCl. Compound NaCl means salt is exhibiting the definite geometric patterns of their constituent particles. If we see a simple representation of NaCl, so NaCl have definite geometric pattern like this. The arrangement of ions are present in this way. The ions are present in a cubic structure and they show the regular or definite geometric patterns of their positive ion and negative ion. While in a case of amorphous solids, these are rubber, glass, plastic, which do not have regular geometries. So this is all about the point of difference between crystalline solids and amorphous solids. Thank you.